Today I'm going to be showing you a bit of my Kintsugi Simple Shader. It is available on Booth for download. This tutorial is primarily for the Kintsugi Shader itself, but it will also serve as a pretty decent texture baking tutorial. Firstly, you want to have the latest version of Blender installed. However, any version after 2.8 should work. And what you're going to need to do is make sure you have the Node Wrangler add-on installed. To do that, you open your Blender preferences, go to add-ons, and search Node Wrangler. You want to make sure that this is checked, and then save your preferences. In addition to that, we're going to have to change our system render settings and make sure that CUDA is selected and that only your primary graphics card is enabled. If you do not have a primary graphics card, you can use your CPU, however, it will be significantly slower. Once you've done that, make sure your render engine is set to cycles, feature set supported, and device GPU compute. Then, down in the Performance tab, we want to open this. Make sure to change these tile samples to 1024 by 1024 for GPUs. Leave them at the 64 by 64 for CPUs. Lastly, we're going to go to the Bake settings and make sure that our bake type is set to Emit. Now that we have Blender configured properly, let me show you how to actually import the shader. So firstly, you can simply open the Blender file, and that will bring you here. Alternatively, if you have an existing scene and want to apply this shader to something else, you can append it. So, in your existing Blender project, you first want to go File, Append, navigate to where the blend file is, and open it. Then go to Node Tree, and select Kintsugi Simple. To apply the shader, switch to the Shading tab. You can either add the shader to the existing material or create a new one. Now, you can delete the principled BSDF, then search with Shift A and go to Groups and select Kintsugi Simple. With Node Wrangler installed, you can Control Shift click and that will immediately connect the material. Now, something that should be noted is Kintsugi Simple, it requires texture coordinates. To do that, we first search texture coordinate. From here, we're going to connect the object node output into the vector coordinates input. After a few moments, you should notice the material appears. You'll notice the texture is a bit smaller than we want it to be, so we're going to add a mapping node. Here, we can adjust the scale and tune it in to exactly where we want. Also, if you want to change how it's arranged, you can move the location or rotation, and that will sort of randomize it. Now, you can play with any of these parameters to tune the material to exactly how you'd like it. Now, in order to bake this to a texture, we first need to add an image texture node. Select New, and I like to bake my textures at 4096. You can name your texture whatever you like. I'm going to name it Bake. Before we bake the texture, we need to make sure our UVs are correct. For that, switch to the UV Editing tab. And what we want is none of these to be overlapping. In order to repack these islands so that nothing is overlapping, you hit A to select all. Then go to UV, Pack Islands. This will rearrange and scale the UV islands so that nothing is overlapping with each other, and will also keep the scale relative to each other. Once you've done that, we can switch back to the Shading tab. Lastly, before we bake, make sure the image is selected as well as the object, and Control-Shift-Click on the Kintsugi Simple material to switch to Color Preview. This viewer node is actually just emission, and that is what we need to bake. So again, select the texture and click bake. Once the texture is done baking, we can preview it here. If you're happy with the result, you can save it by clicking up here and save as. Name it whatever you'd like. I will name mine Albedo 4K. Make sure to save it as a PNG with RGB alpha. You can choose your color depth, but I find the default settings are usually perfect. You can repeat this process with the metalness and roughness. And again, make sure the texture is selected before you click bake. When the metalness is done baking, save that as well. And lastly, we can bake the roughness, making sure to select the texture once again, and bake. Once that one's done, again, save the image. And now, to make the normals, the process is a little bit different. You want to first reconnect the Kintsugi Simple shader to the main output. And in the bake settings, switch from emission to normal. Once again, make sure the texture is selected, and bake. Once the normal map is finished baking, save that one as well. One other thing that should be noted is baking texture should be the final step, or one of the final steps that you do in Blender. Something to double check is that you don't have any other modifiers besides the armature on a model. Something like subdivision surface, decimation, bevel, or any other modifier that changes the geometry or changes the UVs will affect how the texture bake turns out. Make sure you have a finalized model before you go to texture bake. If you changed your UV islands at all, you will have to re-export your model with the current UVs in order for the textures to apply properly. Once all your textures are baked, you will need to combine the metalness and the roughness into a metalness with smoothness alpha texture. To do this, I'm using GIMP, which is a free software similar to Photoshop. Drag in your metalness and roughness texture, and GIMP will open both of them. Go to the roughness texture. First, we need to invert the roughness map to a smoothness map. To do this, click Colors, Invert. Copy the image with Ctrl-C, and now we move to the metalness texture. To add the smoothness as an alpha layer, we first need to right-click the metalness texture and add a layer mask. Any option is fine, I'm going to leave it at the default. Then, paste the roughness texture. Lastly, we need to anchor the floating layer. Once it is applied as a layer mask, we now need to export the new texture. To do this, go File, Export As. Make sure your file extension is PNG, and I like to add in parentheses, Smoothness Alpha. Click Export, and I typically leave all these settings the same. Once that texture is exported, we can go into Unity. Once in Unity, you can import the albedo, metalness with smoothness alpha, and normal map. You can also import your model. Now we need to set up the material, so create, material, and add each texture. We will need to make sure Unity knows that the normal map is a normal map. If you want to see the full resolution, make sure to select all the textures and change their max size to 4K, or you can leave this at the default 2K that Unity imports them as. And now we can apply the material to our model. Other tweaks that you might want to change is the normal strength. You can manually type a value in here. And smoothness. In order to take the smoothness past 1, you have to enable debug mode. Parameters can be found under saved properties, floats, and gloss map. To make it slightly more reflective, try to stay under 2. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and if you're interested in checking out this Kintsugi shader, it is available for purchase on my booth. The link is in the description.